Hi, how are we doing?
Derek.
Good, thanks. How are you?
All right, yes, thanks.
Good.
Yeah, right, we're all good. Derek, obviously, we were just speaking to Neil Lennon before, and there seems to be a certain sort of parallel, if you like, where you've got a noisy small section of supporters that have been disappointed, let's say, about how the club's been performing regarding their expectations. Can you sort of be sympathetic or empathise with Neil and the situation he's in at Celtic as well?
Yeah, I think as a manager, when you take the role on, you've got sympathy for the challenges that all managers have to go through at some stage. It's can't always be a bed of roses, and if it was, it'd be great. But reality and life, you get thrown challenges and difficult periods that you've got to navigate your way through. So, for myself, we've been through tough times before, and you've just got to trust yourself, trust your team, trust how you work to get through it, knowing that there's better days ahead, and that's what we continue to strive for.
You touched on it previously before that obviously it was the perfect kind of storm of Scott leaving and Hedges getting injured. Do you feel now that the extra days you've had that you can bring this squad together and get that bit more out of them that will make you competitive tomorrow night?
Yeah, I think they're certainly competitive. I think the players are given working extremely hard, but to try and bring those qualities at the top end of the pitch, the movements, the passage of play, the qualities we say to try and make a difference between 1 point and 3 points is what we're searching for at the minute. I think Saturday is a tough game to judge anybody on, for both sets of players, the conditions. But I do think in general that, we've got to readjust. This is the squad we've got to work with, and we believe in the talent that we've got here, and it's just try to get them up to speed as quickly as possible. It's not waiting for a few weeks down the line. Our need is now, and we need to try and get those performances from the boys. I think that the effort is there. There's a willingness there. The motivation's there for the players. It's just try to bring all that together, get a bit of confidence into them, and nothing would help that more than getting a big win, some big results between now and the end of the season. So hopefully we can get a big performance tomorrow, positive result tomorrow night at Celtic Park, and that will help us no end. But I'm confident that the boys that we've brought in certainly are of a level that can help us. We just need to be understanding, but also show our desire to get them up to speed as quickly as we can. Some encouraging signs from everyone that we've brought in January there.
It's maybe an unfair question to ask in terms of course, you want a win, you want a positive result, but in some ways, it's the performance, the key thing tomorrow night that you can show the signs of the improvement and the
Not really. I think at this stage in the season, Chris, it's you take result over performance, and I think we've, a lot of the performances we've had of late, some of the draws we've had, we've been pleased with a lot of the work we've done, but nothing really to show for it other than a point or a clean sheet. It's not about clean sheets tomorrow, it's not about points at this stage of the season. It's wins that get the job done, and we just need to try and find ways to get more wins between now and the end of the season for us to achieve what we want to achieve. So that's basically it in a nutshell. We can talk about big performances, but if we got a scrappy victory tomorrow, we'll take that over anything.
Best of luck. I know there's a lot of guys who want to chat to you.
Hi, Derek. Given the current run that the team's on, some might say Celtic away tomorrow night is a game that you could do without. What would you say to them?
Yeah, I think it's a tough challenge anytime you go to Celtic. They've always been the team that's there to be beaten over the last few while, over the years. I think Celtic obviously had their own struggles with that consistency through the league this season, but I think what you've seen recently from them is they've settled down, they've knuckled down. There's been a wee bit of more familiarity about the lineup and the consistency of that. But the biggest factor for Neil probably his team is he's got his front players firing again. Edward has been instrumental in that. Even Sunday's game, very tight game, but he comes up with a couple of big moments, really. Not just him, but there's a lot of talent in that front line. If it's Christie, Rogic, Turnbull, Griffiths, Edward, Elyounoussi, they've got boys there. Forrest Mutton working his way back. So there's boys there that can make a difference. But the difference is between from the last few weeks and maybe previously, Edward is the one making the difference, and we've got to be mindful of that. So challenge question, go to Celtic Park. Nobody really probably give us a chance, since Celtic have picked up. But we've got to go and show the courage, the belief, in the performance. You know, certainly to go and make people think differently and try and get that result, that much needed result that we would that we'd all love.
And obviously, given the barren run the team's on without scoring for a few games, there will be that extra spotlight and onus, won't there, on Hornby, Camberry and Henry. But how important is it that they take all that on their shoulders and maybe even thrive on it?
Yeah, I mean, I think these boys have all came from a period where they've not been playing, you know, and that is the gamble when you take players in January like that, you get them for a reason. But these boys have the qualities, you know, we feel that. And it's getting them up to speed and, you know, taking that responsibility is part of the deal when you sign for Aberdeen. You've got to meet that responsibility. But it's everybody in the team. It's not just the front players. I've said this before. You know, you see more successful teams. It's not just their number nine that's scoring goals. It's, you know, their wide players, midfielders, defenders at set play. So there's no doubting that we need to try and show more of a punch at the top end of the pitch. And hopefully we can show that tomorrow.
You only get 3 points for a win, obviously, Derek. But, you know, victory tomorrow night at Celtic Park, that would mean so much more than that, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I think it would, you know, a huge shot in the arm. But got to go and earn it, got to go and work for it. And that's what we intend to do.
And just finally for me, Derek, obviously, the longer this run goes on, the you know, every time Aberdeen have a poor result, the kind of noise from certain quarters builds. What are your thoughts, given that you know the chairman took the move to postpone his live Q&A, a wise move?
Well, I wasn't involved in the arrangement of that in the first place, and I wasn't involved in the cancellation of it. That's up to the chairman. You know, I think for us, we just need to knuckle down the football side and just concentrate on the job in hand, and that's what we intend to do. Myself, and the players take responsibility for where we are, and it's our responsibility to navigate our way through this. We've been through tough spells before and we've always done that, so we're confident we can do exactly that.
Okay, cheers, Derek.
Hi, Derek. It's Keith here. When I looked at the league table, Derek, when I heard I was speaking to you today, I think I was expecting to be further down given the lack of goals and results, but I mean, you're right in the mix still for the top three, aren't you? There is still plenty to play for despite the poor form.
Absolutely. You know, and I think, Keith, as you know, that it's your form between now and the end of the season for most teams, whether it will sort out the teams that normally win titles in leagues, teams that sort out European spots, top six spots, relegation. So it's really the onus and responsibility to deal with what's ahead of us, not rather than what we've went through. So we're confident we've got enough about us as a team that we can get the desired results and try and meet the expectation on us, which obviously we want to qualify for Europe again, and we want to try and demonstrate the form that we feel we're capable of between now and the end of the season. So we know exactly where we are. We've the run that we're on at the minute has allowed us to lose that third spot for time being. But to be fair, we've been up and down third and fourth all season, the majority of the Hibs and ourselves. So, there's still time for that to change, and that's what we need to focus on, to be honest.
Do you think that the goal drought in recent games is that been solely a cause of the changes that you've had to make in the striking department with obviously little time to make those changes?
Yeah, not solely. I think there's been games where we've had opportunities, we've created opportunities to score goals, and obviously missed chances is part of it. You know, but we'd like to try and bed in these players that we've brought in the last day of the window as quickly as possible. It's important for us to be the team we want to be between now and the end of the season. It is important that these boys are integrated. They do try and catch fire. They do try and get up to speed quickly. Obviously, we couldn't bring them in until the sale of Cosgrove went through. But, you know, we are where we are. We've got to take full responsibility. But it's not just, right, bring new lads in, everything's all rose in the garden. We've all got to take responsibility to help them integrate, to help them be part of the team, but also as a team to contribute, score more goals. It's number nine that can win you a game.
Do you worry, Derek, the lack of goals is maybe playing on the lads' minds a little bit?
I think I've been through this before. As a manager, as a player, sometimes I've played with strikers and front players when I played that you knew they were on the part that they were always going to score. And it's a great feeling that as a team, you know. And I think there's also been times where, you know, maybe front players are lacking a wee bit of confidence, you know, and that is part of the game. You know, I think for us, you know, I think a win tomorrow night and a couple of goals would be the perfect medicine for us the way we're feeling at the minute. But you know, it's not to say that, you know, we've picked up some draws and some clean sheets and stuff like that, but it isn't about that now. It's about wins at this stage of the season and getting momentum. And the only way to do that is by obviously scoring more in the opposition, and that's what we intend to do, hopefully tomorrow night.
Thank you.
Hi, Derek. You were talking there about bedding the new players in, and finally managed to get some minutes on the pitch for Camberi at the weekend after the work permit delays. Just how important is it to have a quality player like him going forward for the rest of the season?
Yeah, I think more than just his quality, Robbie, to be honest. I thought he was very infectious, full of enthusiasm at the weekend and eager to impress. You know, that sort of approach was really good to see. Florian's knows the league. He's shown his capabilities before in the SPFL. You know, I think somebody like him can certainly help the situation. But we're keen to get... There's also an understanding for us that, you know, he's not had 90 minutes for months and months. Big Fraser's not been playing, and Callum Henry's not had a lot of starts. So, so there's that understanding, but there's also that kind of, know, that need and that responsibility getting put towards them. But I believe all three are desperate to play their part. So I think Saturday, in terms of Florian, was a kind of step in the right direction for us. It gives us the confidence, and I think he's eager to show and demonstrate how good he is, and hopefully can help turn things around for us.
And talking about those steps in the right direction, as we were kind of touching on earlier, there is some frustration from fans at the moment. What message would you give to them that things will hopefully get better soon?
Yeah, we take full responsibility for the situation we're in. You know, it's our job now to try and get us out of it. And hopefully we can finish the season strong. And then hopefully at the end of the season is the time for me where I reflect on whether we've had a good campaign or not. That's always the way. People were telling me 2 months ago it was our best start in 20 years in the league. People were saying that to me, our second best start in 20 years. People were telling me at every press conference, this is the best squad you've had. Now, we've had to deal with, you know, bring a lot of money in through player sales. We've had to contend with a lot of injuries, you know, Lee, Hedges and Devlin probably out for the season. You know, that's not ordinary. That's unusual to have so many players out for such a long period of time. So the test for the squad being judged as the best squad we've had for a long time, as I said then and as I say now, is at the end of the season. So we've still got it all to do, and hopefully we can, as I say, do exactly what we want to do.
Great, thanks, Derek.
Derek, when you bring in players who haven't had the game time of your other players, is there anything you can do to get them up to speed in between games, or is it just a matter of getting them minutes in the park?
It's a wee bit of a catch 22, because you put more work into them players who have not had a lot of game. It takes them a bit longer to recover for the game. So Monday predominantly for Sunday, Monday really for Florian and Fraser really was just kind of trying to manage their training time really, and manage their time with physio so that they're ready to do a full session today and ready for the game. You know, it's not just a case of play the game and then work them, build their fitness up through the week in between games, because then it's like flogging a dead horse for the game. So we're just trying to get their minutes through the games really, and just be careful what we're doing in between the games. But you know, next week we have a full week from Saturday, and then that might be a better week and a better situation to top up their fitness work as well. These boys have been training a lot, but they've not been playing. And there is, as you know, there's a huge difference in that.
Yeah. Any other team news at all?
No injuries for the weekend, thankfully. Just on the longer term injuries. Mikey Devon's still progressing slowly, but not anywhere near quick enough to be involved anytime soon. Greg Lee will go through his operation in London on Saturday on his hamstring, which we busy's about for the season. And young Ryan Hedges got his operation in Manchester last Friday, and as expected, he'll be in a sling now for 6 weeks, and then it'll be a slow recovery from that point of view for him. So you know, what we thought 3 to 4 months is what we still think.
Okay, right, thank you.
That's right, cheers man, thanks.
Thanks Derek, good luck.
I'll send that on to you guys, cheers.
Thanks Chris.
Thanks Chris.
Cheers Chris.